turns off an influencer. An influencer to me is someone who has so much value, so much benefits for you to be wanting to be around him or her. An influencer has the ability to increase your human capital, meaning network. They can connect you to the right people, and also finance capital, means money. They are able to teach you knowledge, experience, strategy that can dramatically increase the growth of your business and ultimately your revenue, profit, and income. So everybody wants to be around an influencer. Everybody wants to work for an influencer. So let me share with you, there are a few things that will guarantee to turn off a real influencer. Notice I say something, a real influencer, not one of those fake influencer, okay? So you have to determine, you have to filter out who are the real one, who are the fake one, okay? So let's say you are currently working around, working for an influencer. Let me tell you what turns them off, all right? First thing, entitlement. Real influencers do not like entitlement. Meaning you walk up to that person and say, I've been working with you for the last 10 years, 15 years. You know what? I need to get a raise. You know what? I need to get my bonus. You know what? I need to be recognized because I've been with you for the last 10 to 15 years. In a real influencer, it's the one of the biggest turnoff if you go up to them and say something like that. Why? Because a real influencer, they are not looking for how long you've been with them. They're looking for how much value have you been added to their company, to their business. And are you continue able to add the same value and increase those value? So entitlement does not click with a real influencer. So if you want a real influencer to look at you, to eventually give you more opportunities, you have to continue to add value after value, not based on how long you've been around them. The second thing that turn off a real influencer is what I say, insecurity. Let me explain to you what I mean by that. I work and mentor many salespeople in my organization. I'm gonna use me as an example. And I mentor a lot of people. And eventually, when some of these leaders grow, they are so insecure being around me. You understand what I mean? The reason is because they always know if I am there, I'm always kind of overshadowing them. And guess what these people is doing? Now they become insecure. They start to manipulate. They start to talk about different things, you know, in the organization, in the sales office, so they can get more credit. You know, he say, she say, you know, JW say this, da, 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 da. So that way they want to get a closer relationship with some of the people in the organization. Influencer does not like that. They don't want any game being played. So if you're being around a real influencer, you have to be comfortable that it's okay for him or her to be much better than you. Does it make sense? But if you start to manipulate and start to become their competitor, it's a turn off because they look at this person as, you know what, you're not secure. I don't want to be around you anymore. The third thing that turns off a real influencer to me is overuse of power and overuse of money. Let me explain to you what I mean by that. There are people who works for an influencer, who works for me, for example, and they're getting closer and closer and closer, and then you know what a lot of people start to do? They name drop. They're using my name. They're using the influencer's name and say, he or she said that, you know, I am so close to him or her, so now you gotta listen to me. Name dropping, right? You are overusing the power. Indirectly, you're using this person's name to get what you want, to make a command, and overusing money. Let's say you have an employee or an account manager working for an influencer. You are the account manager to work for an influencer, and you have their credit card, you have their bank account, and you go out there and you spend their money like you're spending their money. They're not a big fan of that. You have to spend their money as your own money. What does that mean? That means if you know an item costs $1,000, if you can negotiate down to $600, you are using their money as your own money, because if it's your own money, you wouldn't be overspending. So if you're overusing power, if you're overusing their money, and you don't treat the company's money as your own money, guess what happened? That's a big turnoff. And the biggest turnoff for working for a real influencer, I say, is you have an agenda. Yes, I said that you have an agenda. Do you know how many people directly and indirectly working for me over the years, I can literally feel that they have an agenda, because the agenda is, if I get to know him, if I get to know her, if I can get close to her, I will get what I want. I will have a much higher position in the company. I will have a much higher position. Guys, I don't know if this all makes sense for you. This video could be very, very, very confusing for some of you. But if you start to build a big organization, you have salespeople around you, you have 1099 independent contractor, you have employee working with you where you're paying a salary, you understand what I'm saying. So if you ever working for a real influencer, I'm just here to give you what are the four biggest turnoffs for working for a real influencer. I hope you learned something from this video today. Please post a comment and let me know your thoughts. See you next time. JW here.